This video belongs to a series with a complete example in which I show how I bring a Blender model to Unity and some extra information about shortcuts and other things that I take into account. In the corner, I leave you the link to the introduction where I show the content of each video so you can watch the complete series or choose the video with the topic you need. In this video, we're gonna see how to create this 3D model in Blender. I'm gonna start by pulling this out of place, press G and then X, and holding Control, I'm gonna move it like so to the back. Now, let's say I wanna create a new object, a plane. First, I'm gonna position the cursor at the origin of the scene, press Shift S and then choose Cursor to World Origin, then press Shift A, Mesh, and choose Plane. Now we have a 2x2 plane. If you enter in the edit mode with the Tab key or with this drop-down menu, select the vertex, here in the item tab with the global coordinates, we see that the position of this vertex is 1 meter for X and 1 meter for Y, so these are 2 meters. Another way to see the length is here in this drop-down menu, in Measurement, activate Edge Length. Then the edges that we have selected will show their length. As you can see, each edge has 2 meters. So now I'm gonna scale it. Press the S key, and maintaining the Control key, we're gonna scale it more or less like this. So the edges are 4 meters long. The next thing is making this little extrusion. For that, press E and notice that here appears a blue axis. That means that Blender is constraining the movement to the Z axis. If you don't see it, just press Z. So we make it more or less like this. The next step is to remove this face up here. For that, I'm gonna enter the face mode. These three modes can be quickly accessed with 1, 2, and 3 on the alphanumeric keyboard. So I select the face, press X, and choose Delete Faces. Then I get this result. Now I select these edges up here and make an extrusion to the outside. For that, I go back to the vertex mode and pressing the left Alt key and clicking on this edge, note that the entire edge loop is selected. That's a quick way to select vertices that are connected and that conform a loop. Now I press E and immediately press right click. At first glance, looks like the vertices were removed, but in reality, they were overlapped with the other vertices. So if you now press the S key and scale up, you get this result. I'm gonna hold Control and we're gonna scale about 2 meters, more or less like this. Now the edge length is 8 meters. Finally, we're gonna make this part here. For that, I press E, press Z to constrain to the Z axis, and I'm gonna type 0.3. That's 30 centimeters. This took me 30 centimeters up, so now pressing the minus sign, Blender considers minus 0.3. Hit Enter to confirm. So, we successfully made the base of the model, not so quick. I'm gonna verify if the normals are okay. For that, I come here to this drop-down menu, and I'm gonna enable back face cooling. Ha ha ha! Notice that these faces became transparent. If we bring the model to Unity, it's gonna look exactly like this. This is because the normal of some faces are inverted. To fix that, we're gonna click in this drop-down menu, and in this section, enable this option, so that the normals appear in the center of the faces. I'm gonna set the size of the normals in 0.5. Normals are just vectors that are perpendicular to the surface, and they are located at the geometric center of each face. So notice that this normal is pointing in this direction. This means that the front of the face is this one. So we have to invert the normals. How do we do that? Well, an alternative is to select everything, pressing A, then press F3, and look for Recalculate. Let's try Recalculate the outside. Notice that now the normals are pointing in the proper direction. I will deactivate the edge length and the normals so they don't bother us. The next thing we're gonna do is the street light. For that we have several options. We can make it a separate object, if we need for example an object that can be duplicated independently from the ground, but in this case I want it to be all one object to show how to set up the materials and the textures. Go to the object mode, press Shift A and add a cylinder. Set it up with 8 vertices. This is gonna be the base of the light. We're gonna scale it a little bit, more or less like this, and now what I'm gonna do is to join these two objects into one. For that, I select one object, press Shift, select the other one, and press Ctrl J. That joins the two objects into one. This could have been done directly here in the edit mode, press Shift A and add the cylinder, but I wanted to show you how to join objects in Blender. If we want to separate this object into a different one, choose a vertex, press Ctrl L to choose all the vertices that are connected, then press P and choose by selection. This separates that mesh into a separate object. But I'm gonna press Ctrl Z, and what I'm gonna do is to get rid of this face below. Go into face mode, select the face, press X, and delete it. Then we select this edge loop up here, and we are gonna start shaping the pole, more or less like this. Scale with S, move with G, restrict the axis, press E, go up. We can give it the height we want, just write the height here, for example 5 meters, 4 meters, whatever you need. I think 4 meters is fine, quite high to be a light from a park, for example. And now we keep repeating this same process. Extrusion, scale, move, now make the hat, scale, extrusion, scale down, and we're pretty much done with the light. What an explanation. Pretty simple. Here we have already solved the problem. What we can do now is normalize the scale. Notice that the current scale is 0.2 for the 3 axis. It's not that it's wrong, but with this, Blender is telling us that this object is scaled down. We are looking at a small version of the real object. I want this to be the real size of the model, so for that we can apply the scale. Select the model, in the object mode press Ctrl A and choose Apply Scale. Now the scale is normalized. The next thing we can do is to normalize the origin. The origin is a special point that every object has and from where the transformations are calculated. In this case, we could place the origin perhaps here in the bottom center. For that, we are going to help us with the 3D cursor. I enter in the edit mode, select this edge loop here below, press Shift S and choose Cursor to select it. That moves the cursor to this position, in the bottom center of the model. So now we go back to the object mode, right click, set origin to 3D cursor. And with this we have the origin where we want. And for example, we can position it at ground level. The last thing I'm gonna do is to give it a more meaningful name. Instead of cylinder, let's call it street, for example. It's not meaningful at all, I know, but still. With this, we already have this model ready to assign different materials. We're gonna do that in the next video. Here apply a ground texture, here a concrete texture. This part is gonna be metallic and maybe a fourth material for the light, like an emissive material. But well, that's for the next video. You'll find it in the end screen. Ah, maldita sea, such a long video, but it's finally done. I hope you find it useful and see you in the next video. Bye.